the ultimate cheat sheet for gold stock investors. Gold and silver stocks are highly levered to the price of the underlying metal, and spectacular gains can enter your investment account at a blistering pace. Double, triple, even more than 10 times your money are all possible, and they can go down 50% just as quick. When silver or gold spot prices rise, you can bet that the catalyst will lift many boats in the sector, even those with gaping holes in the hull. While those gains are realistic when the cycles churn in investors' favor, paper profits can also evaporate in the blink of an eye. While junior gold and silver stocks get all the glory, they're also the ones that carry some of the highest risk in the resource stock market. Let me explain some items that need to be on your resource stock cheat sheet. Junior gold stocks have one major issue that no one likes to talk about. They lack liquidity. Liquidity is the amount of dollar volume the junior company trades on a publicly listed exchange every day. Most juniors trade less than $250,000 a day in volume. That's peanuts for a publicly listed company. On that type of volume, even a single moderately sized order of $100,000 or $200,000 of buying would send the share price up over 20% in a day. That's seen in this chart that you're looking at right now. This is the main reason big investors, family offices, or large funds avoid the junior mining sector. Sure, they could offer the company a bought deal financing, but what if the funds want to sell? Good luck selling your large position into a stock that trades $100,000 worth of volume a day without hurting its share price. Now, some of the retail investors say, well, that doesn't bug me. I might have 5 or 10 or 20 grand into the stock. But it does affect you because you need to know who the other investors are and how their selling action will affect your valuation. Even if the bet pays off, how do you sell? The liquidity match just doesn't work for most of these funds. It's just way too much risk. Regardless, gold is up $400 over the past year, and brokers and companies have been aggressively financing all year. There have been over $4 billion in equity financings this year, funding these junior and mid-tier companies. Most of those shares that have been issued from the $4 billion in financings have been restricted. That means the investors have not been allowed to sell. But those shares are now coming free trading. And a major question you should be asking yourself is, who is going to absorb or buy those shares when they go free trading and those investors start selling the stock? Our in-house analysis is telling us something important. Although mining stock prices are rising, the total dollar amount of financings are not increasing at the same rate. Let me explain what that means. You can attribute this trend to three different factors. The first one, the prices are rising faster than the liquidity rise and the financings are happening. That is not the case when compared to previous cycles. The bigger funds and the generalist funds have not yet gotten into the mining financings like they have in the past. And the third one, passive funds are focusing on ETFs rather than on equities. Numbers three is where I believe the significant changes compared to previous cycles. Passive management funds are primarily buying gold exposure ETFs rather than mining ETFs and mining financings of the mid-tiers and juniors. The chart you're looking at right now is the fund flow into the GLD is over $25 billion versus the net outflow of over $2 billion in the mainstream gold miner ETFs. So GLD is direct exposure to actual the metal gold. And when you look at the red line, that's the ETF GDX and GDXJ exposure to mining equities, so the mining companies. As you can see, the yellow line had an over $25 billion inflow. That money came into the gold price, whereas the red line has had $2 billion leave the ETFs. Even if passive funds were buying direct mining company exposure ETFs like the GDX and GDXJs, those ETFs rarely finance junior exploration, nor do they finance mine construction via debt instruments or streams. Now they do finance the streaming companies. The Catoosa playbook, the boom, the bust, and the echo. Please pay attention to this next section. There's more to a cycle than just a boom and bust or the bull and the bear. There is the alligator. The alligator is much older, wiser, and has been on the planet for over 100 million years longer than either the bear or the bull. To be rich in the stock market, one must be able to survive many cycles and come out stronger And that is what the way of the alligator is all about. There's also a sideways market that always appears somewhere between the last bust and the next boom. And it also occurs in many microcycles between these corrections. It's called the echo. Hence, boom, bust, and echo. Yes, I created this concept over 6 years ago, and it will be the basis of my new book coming out soon. The sideways market is an integral part of the process with the unique and definable features. Understanding how the three cycles work can make the difference between succeeding in the markets and failing, like most do. I've tried to explain this concept to others in the investment business many times over the years, often to deaf ears. I got the distinct feeling that my words were just bouncing off and returning to me, like an echo. And that's how I first got the idea and how the boom, bust, and echo came to be. The Catoosa focus, investing in gold and silver stocks like an alligator. I've refined my approach over the years, and while I take the occasional punt on a junior resource stock, my main focus is to find assets that have had a lot of work done on it by other people, meaning OPM, other people's money, with incredible potential in lower risk jurisdictions that have been left for dead in the previous cycle. How do I go about finding the best assets and management teams? Let's break it down with a recent project my team and I have done. My goal is to identify single producing projects that are not owned by majors, located in positive swap line nations, potential to produce at least 100,000 ounces of gold per year. There are over 700 producing gold mines in the world. After running the criteria through my database, I came up with a list of 89 potential mines. I then eliminated the following: lower grade projects, projects with short mine lives, meaning less than 8 years with no exploration potential to increase the mine life. I also got rid of high cost mines, cash costs of over 800 per ounce. General rule of thumb, if it costs 800 in cash costs, the all in sustaining costs will somewhere be between 12 and 1300. From the remaining list, qualitative digging was performed on each project. Who would it be a good fit for? Does mining the deposit require unique skill set which discourages many new potential suitors? Are there any potential synergies with mines operating nearby? Is there some low-hanging fruit to be plucked which creates additional value for the buyer? For the gambling trader, this simply isn't exciting enough. That group would rather place bets on super high-risk plays in hopes of mansions, Ferraris, and women who will take all their gold and hang out on their leased boats. And the management teams of those companies are more than happy to take your money. You can subscribe to most of the other newsletter writers for those stock picks. The criteria I've outlined has helped me identify more winners than losers, and I'm able to place very large bets on the outcome because I know there will be a liquidity and an exit point. I mentioned earlier that there was $4 billion of shares of mining companies that were restricted that are now coming free trading that may hit the market. That usually means there will be significant selling pressure and lower share prices usually result. In my latest monthly issue, I identified 6 companies which may be punished unnecessarily by free trading paper hitting the market this fall. Do yourself and your portfolio a favor and make sure you know when all the financing paper is going free trading in the companies you own. Stay safe.